But let's put the focus now on Thermax. This is a company that's bagged a 503 crore rupee order from a public sector fertilizer company. Now, the plan is to set up a 320 megawatt natural gas-based cogeneration power plant. The timeline for that is about 22 months. Really understand the dynamics of this order and get an outlook for the business going ahead. We're joined by M.S.Unnikrishnan, Managing Director at Thermax. Mr. Unnikrishnan, thanks so much for joining. Good to speak to you again. First off, let's talk about this latest announcement. Could you just walk us through the basic details as to the recent order win and the company that has won this order?
Yeah, this is a PSU fertilizer company operating in multiple parts. These are for three different locations of theirs in Panipat, Bathinda, and Nangal. Currently, where they are using coal as a fuel for generating steam and electricity they are buying, we'll be supplying them three gas turbines, each of them generating 20 megawatt of electricity, and the waste gases coming out of the gas turbine will be put through a heat recovery boiler, and steam will be produced out of that hot gases, which will be used in the plant. So it is one of a unique case where both electricity and heat are going to be produced by the same plant. So the two clear-cut aspects are, one is avoidance of combustion of a dirty fuel like coal and bringing in a clean fuel like gas. So it's a pollution reduction and carbon footprint reduction, and the overall efficiency of the plant will substantially go up. So the energy consumption of the plant will come down, making this fertilizer plant more viable and maybe more profitable. And the timeline is already started. Within 22 months, we're going to complete all three plants at three different locations. And that's about the project. And we have geared up. We have done similar kind of work for RCF in near to Bombay. And that plant is just about commissioned. And there are multiple fertilizer plants in the country who will eventually go for it. And I'm expecting many others who are currently burning coal as a fuel can naturally shift into gas with the availability of natural gas improving in the world. So it has got a lot of strategic importance for the country. And we have domestic capability to design and engineer a complicated plan like this.
All right, so that's as far as this latest order win goes. In fact, Mr. Unnikrishnan, if you could give us a sense, what does the order backlog look like at this point?
Well, our order backlog is, as a group, is in excess of 5,500 crores rupees, which is almost 25%+ more than the last year's same time. So it's a lot more better than what it was last year.
All right. And I also wanted to get a sense as to the Indonesia plant, because manufacturing and orders have started at that plant. What are the utilization levels looking like? And if you could give us a sense of an outlook that you have for, this market, let's say, going into fiscal 19.
Our real filling of that factory would happen from next year, as you mentioned about Nibrita. We are getting good number of orders, not only from Indonesia. That plant is intended to be catering to the standard boiler sales of the company for the ASEAN region, which will comprise of Indonesia, Malaysia, Philippines, Thailand, Vietnam, and Cambodia. Because the ASEAN has got an agreement that if you manufacture in any of those countries, you can move the material without paying import duty into the entire ASEAN region. So that is the purpose of setting it up. And I need to say, from the way we are getting inquiries and orders in the last quarter and a half since we started the operation of the factory, had been very positive. I would expect that factory to be running at maybe a break-even level in FY 2021, not prior to that, because engineering factories do take a longer period of time to come to break-even level. So I would imagine that I should be able to at least have a 35 to 40% capacity utilization next year. Year after that, crossing 50, at around 60%, I'll have a break-even happening in 2021. So it's moving exactly as per the plan, and I'm very happy that we are localizing our operations over there, and there is no competition of the similar kind of a stature available. They are all small companies over there, so we have a premium position in that market, being the first mover in that market.
All right. So, you know, sounding positive as far as that market goes, and FY21 is when you're expecting a break even. Just a last question, you know, raw material prices had impacted third quarter margins quite a bit. How are things looking in the fourth quarter? Are you expecting things will remain at the same level? Will it be a similar case as far as raw material prices go?
Thankfully, there had not been any further upsurge in the raw material prices. However, whatever had been the carry forward orders where there would have been an impact may continue. But since Q4 normally for companies like us are the highest in terms of top line, normally the margin impact would be better off in the last quarter. So I'm expecting that going forward, we should be able to improve the margin for Q4. And of course, with the higher carry forward orders, we should be able to be at least retaining or bettering the margins in the coming year too.
All right, then which are the segments, sir, where you're seeing, you know, significant growth at this point? What are you really keeping in focus, especially as we go into the next fiscal?
In the domestic market, we are seeing an improvement in the inflow of inquiries from the consumer-facing industry, starting with food processing, textiles, alcohol, beverages, light engineering, durables, pharma, tire industry, auto ancillaries. A lot of them are investing in anticipation of an improvement in the economy, which is already visible. The manufacturing numbers are improving. And I am seeing that to be continuing irrespective of any political uncertainty within the country. Similarly, as a global player, we are also seeing a stability in the global market, subject to nothing going wrong in a massive way in the globe related to politics. I would presume that we should be seeing a better year next year, not only for Thermax, but for those who are participating in the capacity building or capital goods industry.
All right, a better year next year. Any targets that you can share with us that you're really, internally as well, any targets that you have in terms of revenue, profitability, even margins?
Yes, but we will be growing by a double digit next year is our expectation on every aspect of it.
All right, double digit growth is the expectation going into next year. I also wanted an update from the two new plants at Dahej and Sri City. Where do they stand now? What has been the development there?
Nivrita, the Dahej plant has already started producing for the last two quarters, and being a highly automated chemical factory of global standards, it would take some time for stability. But I would say that between the December, January and February, we have been able to double the production from there, and I'm expecting it to be reaching to 1,000 meter cube per month, which is a kind of rated capacity for the current size of the plant. We should be able to be there by June, July. So that's a peak we'll be reaching. So that's very good news. And this is a plan which is designed by Thermax itself, because there is nobody who was willing to or available who could design a plant of this kind, automating a chemical factory of this kind. So it's a good news. Second, Sri City is nearing completion in terms of construction. The trial production should start in the Q1 of the coming year. And I would believe that by Q2 in September, we should have regular production happening for absorption chillers, which are predominantly meant for the international market, with two feeder ports available in Krishnapatnam and Chennai from there. So that should also be coming into stream next year. So next year, my capacities with the Indonesian plant coming to a full stream of availability, chemical coming to full stream of availability, as well as the Sri City for the absorption chillers, the product business of the company should see a higher installed capacity, making me capable of improving the turnover at a faster pace, which gives me a confidence to give you that kind of a commitment that we'll grow double digit next year.
All right, fair enough. Double digit growth, that's what we have to look forward to, Mr. Unnikrishnan. Thanks so much for joining in. That's Thermax for you. The latest updates as far as the Indonesian market and a couple of new plants as well, and the outlook going into fiscal 19. But let's put the focus now on the telecom space. We have January telecom data out. We saw Airtel maintaining its lead once again with a market share of almost 30%. Let's bring in Piyush Jain as well as GV Giri, telecom analyst at IIFL. Piyush, I'll